Rebecca Culbertson.
Jingle all the way with our Coleraine Christmas Radio.
I'm now joined in the studio by Chief Inspector Ian McGee. Good morning, how are you doing today?
Good morning, Rebecca. I'm absolutely class and thanks for bringing me in.
It's fantastic to have you in here. This is a very busy time of year for the PSNI.
Well, it's always busy, but especially coming from Christmas, our problem now at this moment in time is people leaving stuff out in their cars and, you know, making it easy targets for people who want to come and steal it and that sort of stuff. So it's just trying to get that message out there. Plus, we'll have season's greetings run at the minute, which is basically, you know, where we're out and we're carrying out the preliminary breath test to make sure that people who are driving on the roads are safe to be on the roads. And because the last thing we want to do is, one, have to go out to somebody's house and deliver a message that one of their relatives has either been killed or seriously injured. Another thing is, imagine somebody sitting down to their dinner and there's an empty seat. So that's the message that we're basically promoting over this period of time.
Especially at this time of year as well, because the weather's been quite bad. I seen the police route last night and it was very foggy or icy on the roads as well. So dad, drink driving on top of that would be awful.
It's what you'd call a real concoction or mixture, which you don't want to mix. And as you say, I was out having a dander there last night, and you could hardly stand up because of the ice. And you saw this morning there were some people getting into their cars. So are we just saying to people, just take your time, give extra time. If you're going out to have a party, don't be drinking. I wouldn't touch it at all, and just get yourself home safely. And you've got a clear conscience if anything does happen, you know that you did drink and you were not involved.
Absolutely. And is drink driving then the main focus for Christmas for the police, or have you other things that really are top of the agenda?
Well, we've got that, but also we've got the antisocial behaviour, we've got the drugs and that sort of stuff. But you know what, because we're working in partnership here with a lot of people in Coleraine, we seem to be getting on top of that. It seems to be really reduced. But what I would say is the Chief Comm was down last week at the carol service, and he said about his main message for Christmas was respect. Yeah. And that's all I asked for, is just think about other people, respect other people, treat them as you'd want to be treated yourself, and you know what, won't go too far wrong. And I think Christmas will be a great time for everybody.
Absolutely, because I work over in the hub.
Yes.
And we have a fantastic community police officers come over to help us, and we are currently working on an antisocial behaviour workshop with over 25 youth in the area, and I always think it's fantastic to really get to know your community police officers, you know, speak to them, you know, especially if they're working within, you know, your community areas and they're coming in to visit you, get to know them and speak to them.
Well, you know, that is absolutely brilliant for you to say that, because we're coming from the other end, that we're telling people get out there and work with your partners, get to know the people, get to know the young people, you know, because people see us, you know, and there's the peelers and all this. We're here to help you, we're here to do as much as we can, but at the same time, if you do something wrong, every action has a consequence, you know.
Absolutely.
But if we can get a grip of that before it gets to that situation, you get to know us, we're human beings. Like, I'm a father, I'm a son, I'm all the rest of it, you know. I hurt and have the same feelings you have, and you apply that, we'll apply that to you apply that to us, and you know what, sure, we couldn't go far wrong, could we?
Absolutely. And so as the public, to come from the other side, what can we do to help the police this Christmas?
Well, all I would say is help us to help you help us, right? Because basically, you know, if you are going out, you know, lock your house, check that it's locked up, and then leave. You know, if you are in the house at night and you're going to your bed, lock the door, put your keys out of the road, just really simple things.
Yeah.
And if you see something suspicious, something that you think's unusual, let us know. And you know, we're talking about cold callers here. Somebody comes to your door or whatever and they're knocking, check who they are. Don't be afraid to make a phone call, because see if they're legitimate, don't stay for too long. And if they do, you know, if they're in a van or whatever, get the details, pass it on to us. I've got a helicopter, you know, we've got police cars. We can go out, we can follow these people and find out who exactly they are and what they're up to, and give you confidence that you're safe in your own house.
Absolutely, that's fantastic, and thank you so much for joining us. And so, would you have a favourite Christmas song by any chance?
Well, do you know what, I'll be really amazed if you'll be able to play this year, but I love Slade and Merry Christmas.
I can definitely find that for you. Thank you so much, Ian.
Thank you.